guys, it's BroKerBros, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Quorum. We're a lot summer off though. I finished off PSG getting this quarter final of the Champions League, and you can see the rewards that I was given. Bayern Munich in the semi-final of the Champions League. I also beat Spurs in the FA Cup semi-final. Oh, well, late me. Hate win. Or just to piss them off. Nah, I'm just kidding. They were defending like motherfuckers. They really wanted to hang on. But I snuck that win right at the end. Just to be a dick. Anyway, hey, off to the Allianz Arena I go. Hopefully, I can get enough this big win to make the second leg not important. I think I have a Premier League match between the two legs. I think it's West Ham. I haven't been able to. I should have really confirmed that before starting recording. But hey! What can you do? And you guys know I record these pretty much one after another with the timing I have. I finished recording the video you saw on Friday about an hour and a half ago. So my video went. No way.
One of the players who's come from South America really been a hit in Europe.
2.5 hours ago.
Four in his last three games.
So my video has since gone live. I've made sure it's all good. Hit audio quad. Hit locked. Check all that. It's all good.
We'll see how.
I took some time and just to chill, just to let my voice heal from my rant, because I ranted. I know. What a surprise! I ranted about Liverpool because they're terrible. And when you're seeing this, it's Monday. It's not Monday when this is being recorded, but when this goes live, it'll be Monday. And it'll be after the weekend where Liverpool probably lost again. Because our form in real life has been terrible. And I'm not going to go over it again. I don't know what Karius is telling the guys what to do. Shouldn't that be the captain's job? Dude! Are you not going to do your job? Should Karius be the captain? If he's the one who looks like he's organizing shit out there, which is what the captain's supposed to do. Or am I completely misunderstanding the job of the captain? Also, this is David Alaba's first game against his former club. And of course, a Liverpool legend is playing in this match as well. Oh, he's sadly retiring Xabi Alonso. You guys did not hear that. Xabi Alonso recently announced that this season will be his last. At the end of this season, he's done.
We could be in.
Disappointing. I was kind of hoping he might come back to Liverpool to do like a Steven Gerrard last season, and where he made a few appearances in Gen. He had like a last test run in the team. I think Xabi Alonso still has a lot to offer as a footballer, but I guess he figures, he's a good age, he's won pretty much everything there is to win. I mean, like, he won the Champions. He's won the Champions League. He's won Bundesliga, his La Liga, his all that sort of stuff. He's even won the World Cup. I mean, the only thing he didn't win, similar to Steven Gerrard, is the Premier League. And correct it to Alonso, he didn't sell his mortality, his morality, just for a Premier League winner's medal. I mean, I'm pretty sure a Premier League team was not up Alonso. Oh, if given the opportunity. There was probably offers for Alonso in his Real Madrid days before he moved to Bayern Munich. Like, from likes of maybe Chelsea, maybe Man City, maybe Arsenal. I wouldn't put it past him. They would go from his time at Liverpool what Alonso could offer. Or they'd be like, yeah, let's get a bit of that in our team. So it would not surprise me one bit if they had made offers, but he just maybe Real Madrid flat out said no, but if they had accepted a bid and we just didn't hear about it, because, you know, sometimes deals come out of nowhere. I mean, some deals will just pop up and you're like, wait, what? You haven't heard anything about this. It's just, this is happening now. And we're like, okay. You say so? But yeah. I generally.
Like a poor pass, but a good interception.
All the great stuff he at Liverpool. I know he played for our club, but Liverpool fans, he remembers for a long runs of how fun he and we
and the task not
we are and I personally kind of hope he maybe goes into coaching or something like that. I don't know what he plans to do after retiring, but maybe we will still see him back at Anfield in some capacity, similar to Steven Gerrard. Maybe they alright, who knows?
Got it away, and that's what you have to do. It's a corner again.
Yeah.
And here's the shot. He's reached it and turned it aside.
That's my opinion on Xabi Alonso. I mean, you guys would have heard me talk about Alonso before on the channel. Well, no question about it.
They are leading, and they have just.
But, yeah.
So the referee.
Really, only.
Champions Cup semi-final. To the point now where nobody could afford to make a mistake.
Said that he just didn't come back for that one final season. Even if it was only one season, every look of. A lot of money he comes. Yeah, we have Alonso playing right again. And I mean, right at Liverpool. No offense about me. because they also wear red. When I say red, I mean Liverpool red. Bayern Munich red. That's... I'm sure their red is, you know, iconic for their club, but... As a Liverpool fan... there's only one red shirt or I wanted to see Xabi Alonso wear. And it wasn't the Bayern Munich shirt or her red Real Madrid away shirt or her the Spain shirt. It was Liverpool red. Unfortunately, he won't see that.
It's looking good, this move. We've had an hour gone.
And since he is retiring, this is the last FIFA that he's going to be in. I mean, speaking of Alonso, he's just gone off. I'd be really annoyed if EA don't give Xabi Alonso a Legends card. Him and Steven Gerrard, stop. EA, if you're paying any kind of attention to me, stop shafting Liverpool Legends. I mean, you know, you're sucking so many Man United Legends. Scholes, Ferdinand, Giggs, all them get fucking Legend cards, and Robbie Fowler's alone, looking around for ages until Jamie Carragher came along. And don't count Michael Owen, because that cunt doesn't deserve a Legends card. He deserves a Traitors card with a big fat zero on it.
Knocked it about with confidence. And as you say, they're two evenly matched sides, so that's been a big achievement for them. Restarting at 2-0. Bayern Munich ready to bring on a sub. No shots at all so far for Bayern Munich.
Freaking joke.
We could be here until midnight, and we still wouldn't see a shot. Comes
the challenge. So, EA, if you're listening, here's what you have to do. I don't care who you have to pay and how much money you have to pay. Hey, get Legend cards for Ian Rush, Kenny Dougherty. Please. Don't they deserve it. They deserve it. I don't care what biased cunt comes along and says, oh, they don't deserve it. They do. Am I seeing that correctly? Renato Sanchez is coming on. Shouldn't he be playing instead of Thiago? Dude must be A7 rated by now, wasn't he? Dude grows really quickly, and he starts off at a 78. Yo, Byron, if you're not playing Renato Sanchez, I might have a bid coming your way in the summer. I could fit Renato Sanchez into my team without a doubt. Dude is a fucking beast. Look at him.
That looked promising, but he's been stopped.
Imagine having as your two central midfielders Renato Sanchez and Tielemans. Oh my god, you'd be set for the next 20 fucking years. As long as they don't up and leave in that time. But if you can nail them down to your club and your club only, oh, you'd be set in the central midfield, because those two, if they gel, oh, you're sorted. You are absolutely sorted. I have purposely stayed away from Tielemans this year, or because I overused him last year. But Renato Sanchez, when Renato Sanchez broke onto the scene in the Europe, it was really late on in FIFA.
a win confirmed for Liverpool.
But if Bayern Munich aren't playing him, I can fit him into my team without a doubt. I mean, I could easily play him over Emre Can or De Hoed or rotate. I mean, without a doubt, I am gonna. That is a heavily considered summer transfer now. And I got the money. I got the money. I mean, just look at my transfer budget if you don't think so. Speaking of Emre Can, oh, you want to sign a new contract, do you? Huh? Well, that seems to be very fucking different from real life, because apparently you don't fucking want to. Who? Are you saying, oh, we're not offering you enough money? Hey, if that's true, who? Who? Then the owners need to. Okay, I'm gonna stop. I'm getting into an rant. Don't do that, Corey. Don't do that. Two videos in a row, people will be really pissed off if I start ranting again. Just gonna say that the owners need to get their thumbs out of their ass and sign Emery to a contract and do not let him leave. Do not sell for him. You're really one of our best players when he is on form. I must specify that on form bit because no one's on form at the moment. So saying he's on form is a disservice to everyone else because Emery is no different. And no, you're not imagining things. That is Kevin Stewart. In fact, Kevin Stewart is going to play, because I'm proving a goddamn point. I really thought, you know, when I agreed to let him go on loan, I was like, this time it'll be different. Nope. Exact same bullshit once again. If you don't understand, This continues a pattern. I put up a player for loan. A Premier League rival comes and takes that player on loan. Middlesbrough, in this case, with Kevin Stewart. I'm like, okay, he'll get some game time, and I'll be able to see how he's doing, because the thing will tell me, you know, how many games he's played and stuff like that. This game with Kevin Stewart's third Premier League game all season. And Middlesbrough are near the bottom of the table. Two games he's played all season and they're near the bottom of the table. So it's not his fault. So, Middlesbrough continue the new trend of I loan a player to a team, I think they're going to give him the game time I'd like, you know, I'm okay if he doesn't play every game, that's fine. I ask a quarter of your games. Half your games. A third of your games. Two he played. He's gonna. This will make three appearances, which means he will have played half the amount of games after only being back for about a week at Liverpool. Well, then he has all season for Middlesbrough. And he hasn't played since I don't know when. He has not played since I don't know when. Because I checked in January, and he had 2 games. He still has 2 games. Which means he hasn't played since at least January. And I checked at the start of January. It's now May. So he hasn't played since at least December. If not earlier than that.
Yeah, maybe they'd fancy themselves.
But I'm not going to dwell too much onto it because I'm ranting again. But I'm done. I am never loaning another player to a Premier League team. If a Premier League team comes in from, I'm just going to ignore the email. Cool. I'm done from in any Premier League team. I'm just done. I'm not going to loan or sell another player to a Premier League team. Oh wow, imagine if he scored that. 6 minutes almost. About 6 minutes into his first game in months. And he would have had a goal. Oh, in one game at Liverpool. And he only played 2 games for Middlesbrough. Again, I'm not going to go too much into it because otherwise I'll just keep ranting. And I don't want to give you guys 2 rants in a row. Oh, technically it's not 2 rants in a row because there's two. There will be 2 secondary Karema videos between this. Give them the number 7. I have to change that.
Staggered, Martin. Really, Al. I mean, if he's not good enough for the club, why play him there? I mean, what the number 2 on the bench will be thinking, I do not know.
Attacking now. Well,
I did consider, ironically, I was considering giving that number to Divo Origi at the start of the season. We'll change him from number 27 into just number 7. Because, for me, you know, big numbers don't really suit strikers. Like, the biggest number I see suiting a striker is maybe 10.
Attacking power in this situation. They passed their way up into a good position here. Just lost the concentration, lost the ball as well.
Maybe 16. But that's only like for like a Sergio Aguero when he was number 16. Now he's number 10 at Man City. Why is that? Because it more suits a striker. 16 is more of a midfielder or more like a defender. Or just certain numbers fit a certain position. And hell, even the number 10 is more commonly associated with the cam position, which is why Coutinho is Liverpool's number 10. Because he's the guy who mainly plays in that position.
Of their jobs, they've settled into a shape. Who knows? Could be glory at the end of this.
But since Firmino is also a cam, that's why 11 suits him. And Mane, a 19 suits Mane because it's like you couldn't give him 9. You know, people or stupid idiots would be comparing what he does to people who've had the number in the past. So, and you can't give him 10 because that's Coutinho's number. So, combined 9 and 10 for 19.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball. Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. Sekou Kouyaté. It goes out wide again.
That's a see-you situation, and on he goes. They've coped with it well defensively.
So, yeah, certain numbers suit certain players. 27 is a number I don't really see often, so I don't know what... I mean, maybe I'll get used to it, but Divock Origi isn't playing! Another head-scratcher from real life. Instead of playing Divock Origi, who was our best striker last season, before Funes Mori showed up. Still waiting for him to get reprimanded for that EA, or FA, sorry. I always get those two mixed up on.
Here we go in the second.
Yeah, seriously, injure Origi intentionally. He then celebrated like he won a fucking prize. He got two games banned. That's it. So you're telling me Luis Suarez bites someone, gets rightfully banned, but some guy almost cripples Divock Origi, and no, I'm not exaggerating. Go back and watch it. Origi is very lucky. That Funes Mori didn't end his career. But Funes Mori didn't get a really big ban. He got a few games and he was back playing. And Everton are still playing him, which is an even bigger stretcher. Because I heard the opinions of the Everton and after them match. Because I went and found the Everton TV. Because I wanted to hear what their guys had to say about it. And they agreed that Funes Mori, he stepped over the line. What he did was stupid. When the fans of the play, of the team that player or plays for, the city rivals, those of that team. I mean, look. Well, Everton are rivals, and the Everton fans are saying that their own player is a fucking dickhead, pretty much.
That's a very good goal, and much deserved the way the team are playing.
So, I'm baffled why he didn't get a longer ban. It is absolutely baffling. Especially when he did it intentionally. It really is baffling.
Payet. Well, no shots at all so far for West Ham.
Well, nobody has taken the responsibility here.
And the fact that he celebrated it like he was a fucking hero. When even the Everton fans were probably like, dude, what the fuck are you doing? You're celebrating that? Like fucking asshole.
Spreading out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack. It's nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and
This might be it. Goal. They lead by two now. Took the chance nicely. And that really has given them much more of a base.
So that's a head scratcher.
Goalkeeper, as it turned out.
No, one or two of these.
Or I don't know why he. No action was taken. But. Lo and behold, no serious action was taken. He served his suspension, now he's playing again.
He went in well. Still 20 minutes to go. And he's threaded the path through neatly.
And what? Well, I'll say to Everton, didn't they have fair right to play him since he isn't banned? I thought they'd have a little more sense. missing that, considering the fans even admitted that the tackle was over the line. And the celebration. Seriously, he was celebrating like he won. That he scored, like he scored the goal-winning game. He was proud of what he did, and yet he didn't get banned.
We've got 10 minutes left on the clock.
Yeah, a player will get a yellow card if he goes over the line with his celebration for a goal.
Go for it in these
circumstances. I genuinely don't understand it. It makes no sense.
I think he had to do it, didn't he? He's not going to go like, with a whip. This manager wants to go down with a fight and
taking your shirt off. Why is that a yellow card?
He was on his toes. He was really fit.
What is it? Because they're getting nude in public? No! They're not getting nude in public! First of all, if someone wanted to get nude in public, why would their shirt be their first option? You know? Well,
3 minutes to be.
Well, surely it would be the box. Right? Am I the only one who sees a massive hole in the logic? And even if the player has like a shirt on underneath, they still get booked. In fact, I think after Luis Suarez's suspension for his which suspension was he coming back from?
Bournemouth 0, Everton 1. Hull City.
Albion 0. I think it was the Ivanovich one.
Crystal Palace 2.
I think it was the Ivanovich one.
Chelsea 1. Stoke City.
But he came back, and in one of the games that he was back, I think it might have been like a Sunderland game or like the game after that. He pulled up his shirt because he had recently had his second child, and he had a nice message for her. Or maybe it was his first he had some message on his shirt, and the referee booked him for that. I mean, I don't want to say he's sending a nice message. I mean, it's, I'm like, what's wrong with that? He's sending out a nice message? Yeah, it's in a foreign language, but he's not going to send out a crude message to his child. Well, I mean, Suarez did some deplorable things in his Liverpool career for buying in racism.
On goal difference. Bottom of the table, Brighton and Hove Albion with 16 points.
But he's not going to send out crude messages to his children, who will probably look back at his career or later in their life. And can you imagine if they see that goal, all they see the celebration, they recognize that, oh, that's me, or that's the other one. And again, I'm not sure which child it was. I know he has two children, and I know it was one of them. It was either the birthday of one, or it was to celebrate the birth of the second one. Now I don't remember. I know he had some message for one of his children. I think it might have been the daughter. I think his second child was a son? I don't know. I don't stalk Luis Suarez. The only reason I even know he has a daughter is because because when he signed for Liverpool, well, his family were shown with him and his girlfriend, and was carrying a girl. Oh, and Sky Sports News even said his Luis Suarez sitting here with his girlfriend and little daughter.
So it was like your crew. You know what, I'm gonna stop trying to explain it. I'm just gonna say thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button and subscribe. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.